Oh shit, that's not coming back out. Don't do this. Yeah, that's annoying. I got that out, in case you're curious, using the screwdriver, the glasses screwdriver bit on my Leatherman Arc. There's a number of ways you could have done that. I don't recommend any of them. You should not do that at all. Don't use a normal cable. Yes, I cut it in frustration just to get it away from what I was plugged into to not have to carry the whole long cable. Don't do that. Do this instead. This is the Starlink 15 meter, or 50 feet for us Americans, mini Ethernet cable. Now, there's nothing else in the box. It's just a cable. Okay. Get rid of that. It's just a cable. Both sides. Ethernet. One's waterproof. One's not. It's designed for the Starlink Mini and the Gen 3 router. First thing I want you to notice is this funny looking, specially designed pressure pull clip, not the official title, which will enable you to avoid what I had to do to my cable just a moment ago. This is important because, as you saw, the port here is quite deep, and if you were to put a regular Ethernet cable in there, number one, it's a pain in the ass to get out, and number two, it's not going to be waterproofed. This cable solves for both. This special clip on here allows you to pull to release instead of having to push down on the clip like in conventional cables, while still including the waterproofing rings that are on here so that you can have it in the elements. Let me show you how this normally works with the other end of this cable. Usually, this little plastic clip on top is designed to literally hold the cable inside the port so that it doesn't come out. You want that to be solid because usually you don't want your network clips coming out. What they've done here on the other side is rather clever. It still clips in just like normal, maybe a little bit less click sounding there, but still able to be held into the actual switch. Now, you shouldn't really dangle a switch in production like this, but I'm doing it to show you that it actually does have some solid pull on it. Until you apply the right amount of pressure to pull it out, it's going to stay locked in. Now, that was pretty solid. What they've done here is some clever engineering of the clip, which allows it to be held in and actually stay there instead of just falling out, which is what a clipless cable would do, while still having the ability to be pulled out without having a clip inside. It's actually rather clever. Now, you should also note, unlike the power cord that comes with the Starlink Mini, where both ends are the barrel tips and are the same and have the waterproofing, this one has two different ends. This is the special one that I was just showing you before, and this is your more conventional looking Ethernet cable clip. This is the end that should go into your laptop or into your router or your Wi-Fi system, etc. This is the end that you want going into the Starlink Mini with the shaved off, funky, specially engineered clip over here. Take a look at how a normal clip works. When you plug it in, it has that nice solid click and you can't pull it out. It's really in there. Now, if we push down in order to remove it, it comes right out. On the other hand, we're not gonna have that clip on this side. If we push this into the switch, we get a similar amount of security that our cable is in there, but if we pull on it, actually rather hard in this switch, other ones less so, but in this one rather hard, it does come right out. Now let me show you what that's like on the Starlink Mini. I'm gonna thread this into the hole here and through the little bracket over here. So I'm threading it into the hole, and it's gonna be a little hard to push in because you are pushing through those waterproof seals. That's how you keep it waterproof. Push that in all the way there, and you can hear it clicks right in, and now you should be able to see it's in there quite nicely. Now, if I want to get it out, I'm just going to grasp the end of the cable and yank it out. Usually, I wouldn't recommend that with Ethernet cables, but this one seems to be engineered specifically for that, so go ahead. This cable costs $35 and is available today in the Starlink store, link in the description down below. I'll be releasing a video shortly on how to take your internet connection from your Starlink, be it mini, business, etc., and plug it into a Unifi network to broadcast over hundreds of acres. So if you're interested in more content like this, please like and subscribe. Uh-oh. Worked on my test rig.